about?
But you have to get the two.
This big red button, or this door, everything, anything.
What are you doing?
I'm hitting the red button twice!
No, it's a pink button, and you have to hit the two!
Listen to him, Stephanie! He's telling us that it's pointless! He's saying that we should just embrace the cool brace
of death! But we don't have to do what he says! You don't get
it! Fine! Blow me up!
Quite a disappointment.
If we're doing the run out the clock playthrough, tell me we're doing the run out the clock playthrough. Otherwise, I don't know why you're running around hitting the wrong buttons.
You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want
seriously,
to watch you
seriously,
every moment.
Hit something more useful. Are you doing the run out the clock?
I'm listening to him. Let me either listen to him or play the f-ing game.
Hello, internet. Welcome to game.
We're a minute early, Jason.
No, we're not.
It is 3:59 according to the TV,
here.
According to this computer.
Not that computer
let
or
me,
this
Let me
computer.
Check my cell phone here. 3:59. 3:59.
My
DT Live, we were early once.
Forgive us.
You should update that phone.
4 o'clock. Hey guys, and welcome to GT Live.
It's four.
Where it is 4 o'clock p.m. on the nose. Apologies to everyone who tuned in starting at 4 o'clock, the time that the live stream is supposed to start. Apologies for you. Jason, having something to prove, having a little thorn in his side, a little chip on his shoulder, is like, I'm going to start the live stream early. Yeah, Jason, 3:15. Man.
We need a meeting to sync clocks because your clock is slow.
I don't think my clock is slow if literally it's this clock, that clock, and probably this
clock
too.
All of your devices.
What device are you using?
That computer, this computer, that cell phone.
I don't see you looking at that computer. You're looking at one computer right now.
Can we have a meeting to sync watches just so we feel like spies?
Today, back by popular demand, we were so excited to be playing Stanley Parable yesterday. We had so much fun with it. You guys seem to have a lot of fun with it. So we're like, hey, instead of like waiting a week like we would normally do on the live stream, let's just play it again.
Let's keep the fun
really
going.
Fun.
Yeah.
Let's continue to explore, find new endings, figure out all the weird little things that you can do in this game.
I'm keeping the Stanley Parable party going. Yeah.
Ain't no party like a Stanley Parable party.
Because that party doesn't end. Oh.
It doesn't
see what
end.
I did
the
there?
End is not the end.
Hey. Oh,
ain't no party like a Stanley Parable party. It's hard to shove that many syllables in there.
That just fell right apart.
So when last we left off, we got a handful of different endings.
We did. We ended with the museum.
We ended with the most meta of endings, which is, I don't know, speaking of this game, who even knows? It was the ending in which they showed you kind of the development of the game, and we kind of killed ourselves. So anyway, here we begin again, which I'm super excited about.
We begin again, but we never ended.
Did we ever truly end? That is the question.
We did. I distinctly remember the live stream stopping.
It did.
Actually,
end. That is correct.
But
yes.
We're picking up again. Wow, this
it's
is
loading.
Really loading. Okay.
We can skip the intro.
Great.
There we go.
Okay.
All right. So, when last we left off our little adventurer, we had disobeyed. We had done a bunch of clicking doors.
Yeah, we bailed at the last minute on one of our things.
Do we want to start off by actually just playing the story through?
I think that's a great place
to start.
Let's start by playing the actual game.
All of his co-workers were gone.
All right.
What could it mean?
Oh, let's make sure we
Stanley
press that one
to go
computer,
to the
though, so we can
Perhaps
keep
he had
loading it
missed
or whatever.
A memo.
Agreed.
No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
Okay.
Keep loading that one computer.
Yeah, we'll keep inputting the computer. Mm-hmm. Which, you know,
Where
if you
it?
Actually think about what that means to the... usually in this room.
Shoot.
That's weird. But it is interesting. If you think about what that computer means for the rest of this game, it means that the game itself, even though you're repeating the same events over and over again, it means that time actually has a memory.
Ooh.
Right? It's almost like Undertale that way, where like, sure, everything seems unrelated to everything else, but like, the game knows.
The game knows how many times you've played before, it knows the decisions you've made, that's pretty cool.
And from a theory perspective, that would actually be pretty significant,
It
right?
would. So, we did learn from the last playthrough that we've seen the map of this office layout
when
at this
Stanley
point.
Came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
So we're gonna go left this time, but we also learned that there are
There
are vents and multiple ways that you can go if you go right.
Let's look at the vent.
No, come on, let's just play through the story first. We agreed to play through the story first.
Fine.
I wanna get that one done. That one's easy.
So we did this.
Yep.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
So last time we branched off was with
Stanley
the boss.
Decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
All right,
to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
All right,
here we go.
Okay, great.
Boss's office. We did all this. Oh, wait, maybe this computer has it? No.
No.
That's weird. I wonder what computer has it. Did we blow it? We might have blown it.
I think we passed. I'm pretty sure we passed it.
Well, I know. I mean, but, like, I wonder why it wasn't there this time.
Right? That's a bit strange. All right, we're in the boss's office. Do we type
Stepping
in the code?
Into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held from him? What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the
terrible
truth.
I bet if you type in something early, the narrator
makes
mention of that he knew it.
There were also some...
And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret.
There were also some inputs that the chat recommended for us last time, like 8888.
Really?
Yep. Which we can try next time.
Let's do it. You want to do it this time?
No, we should follow the story this time.
So wait, what was it? 2845?
Yeah.
I wasn't paying attention.
I forgot.
We'll see.
Yep, and I see everyone in the chat saying 8888. We'll try that one next time.
Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Okay.
You're brilliant, Stanley.
So here, go downstairs. Whee!
Whee! Oh, man. Flying through.
Right? Look at us.
This is like a Stanley Parable peed run?
Peed run.
Peed run. Speed run. Or a peed run. That's what Jason had to do earlier.
He did make a peed run.
He did make a peed run.
And killed a baby to do it.
Free to think for himself. To question the nature of his
hold it a little bit, man.
Why did he feel this now?
What's 4 hours?
It had never occurred to him. This question would not go unanswered for long.
Okay. So last time... The last ending that we got.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Oh, man.
So this is how we got the museum ending, was by going through Escape, which then it's like, you're going to certain death. And then we did get crushed.
Yep, that was it.
So Mind Control Facility. So we have not done any of this.
All right, let's go.
Cool. This is fascinating. Nothing really to do. I can't jump off.
No, remember we're following the narrator for this one too.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens.
Ooh.
What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
He does.
Oh man.
He does have the strength to find out.
He's so strong.
And he's so obedient to your instructions, narrator.
Oh, narrator.
Oh, great narrator. We shall follow your every command.
Whoa,
all
right. Ooh, cameras.
Cameras and computers. I guess it's just fire up the cameras then.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, let's do it.
Yep.
Now,
I love how the buttons are
their true
so nicely
revealed.
Laid out.
Ooh,
each
fire.
Bore the number of an employee in the building.
Whoa.
Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen. And Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place. Where freedom meant nothing.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Where is my office? So that's the boss's office, right?
It?
Even the boss is monitored.
Huh.
That's weird.
Yeah.
So like that's
Mind
the boss's
control.
Office. That's interesting. Oh, wait, ooh. 427. Shoot, there I am.
427, okay.
Oh yeah, that is my office.
We don't have the worst office in the building.
Well,
hey!
I wonder if next time we're in our office, if we can like tamper with that
camera.
And
yeah,
if it'll do anything.
I wonder.
That would be so cool. Okay, so what do we do here?
Oh, there's something on the screens now.
Just like a do not do something.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll just walk this way.
All right, fine. Move in.
It is weird that the boss would monitor himself, though, so it means that the boss is not actually in control of any of it.
I wonder.
But that's just...
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time?
I mean, so far it's just like an elaborate security system.
That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Cool. Well, the narrator. Everyone's under the control of the narrator. So the narrator is the true... like villain of right?
Well, it seems like it, right?
Although it does bear...
He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible?
It's actually, spent his it wouldn't be the narrator, it would be you. It would be the player.
Blind to the world.
No, it would be the narrator.
Are you sure?
Because the player...
The player is following the narrator's instructions,
The player is following the narrator's instructions.
But the player has the power to choose whether or not to follow the narrator.
It's true.
Mind control means you're just under someone's control.
But here was the proof. The heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions. Ooh. Happy or sad or content. Ooh. Walking, eating, working. All of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Huh. It would be great if it connected disconnected your keyboard from the game. Come on. Use it.
I need to
destroy
it.
Use this power.
Right? What about Stanley taking control of this?
Right?
And controlling literally all the other employees.
Yeah. It is Stanley.
Throw myself into the machine.
Right?
It's like a Mass Effect ending. Throw myself in to synthesize or destroy.
Where's the button?
There's a 5.
All right.
I found a 5 button. Ooh, mind control's idle, awaiting input.
Oh, okay. Maybe we try and press the 5?
Yeah, I think we maybe press the 5. Ooh. What
else? Ooh. There's another one over there.
There's a blue screen.
Ooh, blue screen.
Console disabled, okay.
I think we go and press the number buttons, maybe? Some number buttons?
No. Shoot.
Start with 1.
There's 1.
There you go.
1. 2.
2.
Where's 3? Have you seen the 3? Oh, there's... Wait.
If there's a 5, there's got to be 3 and 4 somewhere.
That would be a fair guess. I would say that is a well-deducted logic, Steph.
It would be so trolly if
it's
didn't
a 4.
It's a 4.
Oh.
Where's 3? Can you see 3 from here?
Do you see what I 3?
Yep. Great.
Thanks. Quality humor, ladies and gentlemen.
Pulling in the little drummer boy. Good to see we're using top quality content.
Stephanie, the little drummer boy is content/quality songwriting that has lasted for decades.
Is there no 3?
There's 3.
Where's the 3?
No, that's 5.
No, that's 5.
That's still the 5. There's got to be a 3. Here it is. Hey-oh! Although
there
I don't think this is helping us obey the narrator. I like that we keep getting distracted by other things. And we're like, oh, we're going to follow the story.
We're trying.
I don't know. I think following the story at this point would be going into that other room.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Hmm. I think so.
Who?
That's what the level design is telling me, but I am really curious what 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is going to do for us.
All right, fine.
It's that human need to just press buttons and see what they do. We're just so curious. I need to press all the buttons.
Morgan Stang thinks we're wasting time.
No.
We're enjoying ourselves playing a video game, though. No, that didn't do anything.
That didn't do anything!
All right, she was right. We were wasting time.
Darn it.
All right, fine. Everything's off. We need to go in the other room.
What if I did it backwards?
Buttons don't do anything? All right, fine.
Are you kidding me? The buttons totally got to do something.
They do something in some other scenario, probably.
Mind control's idle. I still want to control it.
And when at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew it was his duty, his obligation, to put an end to this horrible place and to everything it stood for.
Electric shock. Stanley, Stanley isn't listening to my commands. We should administer an electric shock.
Administer a controlled shock.
You want to put him on? We're following the narrator.
So what do we think is going to happen?
We're following the narrator. We're going to find out. Here it is.
Any predictions?
Blackness and a rising chill of uncertainty. Was it over?
Does not appear to me.
Yes. He had won. He had defeated the machine. Unshackled himself from someone else's command. Freedom was mere moments away.
I have no idea where this is going.
Even as the immense door slowly opened, Stanley reflected on how many puzzles still lay unsolved.
Right? So many.
How had his co-workers gone? How had he been freed from the machine's grasp? What other mysteries did this strange building hold? But as sunlight streamed into the chamber, he realized none of this mattered to him. For it was not knowledge or even power that he had been seeking, but happiness. Perhaps his goal had not been to understand, but to let go.
Oh, that's nice.
No longer would anyone tell him where to go, what to do, or how to feel. Whatever life he lives, it will be his.
Oh, this is so nice.
And that was all he needed to know. It was perhaps
this is the best ending we've got so far.
Stanley stepped through the open door.
Oh, I was hoping he would do it without you.
Right? That would have been funny, because then...
That would have been the right thing.
Well, there's so many layers of meaning here, right? Because we're still under the command of the narrator.
It's true.
Stanley felt the cool breeze.
So now I don't have control.
The feeling of liberation. The immense possibility of the new path before him.
This game is great.
This was exactly the way, right now, that things were meant to happen. And Stanley was happy.
Stanley
so happy.
Yes! What a good... Yeah. What a terrible high five. We beat the game!
Hey! Nice!
Is that really the end?
That
That's
so
cool.
Easy.
I like
the
that.
The end is never the end, Matthew. Huh.
That was good.
Oh,
I like that
man.
One. That was... Was this always here, or was this just something that I've never noticed, but now has new meaning?
Right? It does. I think it was already always there.
I think so, too.
Where's the camera?
Yeah, let's look at the...
It was supposed to be right up there.
The angle of how it was looking into our room
was from over in that corner. Is it in the filing cabinet? That thing?
Right? It should.
I think it's that yellow thing.
It's not letting me do anything with it, though, unfortunately.
Shoot.
Damn you, Stanley!
All right.
No, you're not allowed to do... I'm really surprised that they would not have a way to, like... dismantle the camera that's in your room or whatever.
Right?
With the newfound knowledge of the freedom ending.
Man.
That was cool.
That was
fun. It's nice to make Stanley happy.
I know.
He didn't want power. He didn't want to, like... It's cool. What I appreciate about that is the fact that all video games are always like, you're the hero of the world. You're the special one. You're the savior. You're
gonna
be... And this one, it's like, yeah, there's a lot of mysteries. Yeah, there's, like, some deeper conspiracy going on and who are the people controlling me and this and that, but...
So is life.
But, like... I'm just a normal guy.
Yeah.
I saved myself.
I'm
no longer under anyone's control. I'm doing my own thing.
Yeah.
That's cool. That's cool. Clap and a half for this game.
Nice.
Well done, game.
That was fun.
So now I want to see what happens in the vent.
The meeting room. Yes, that's where everyone would be. Stanley just needed to get to the meeting room, and from then on, he would never be alone ever again.
Huh.
Really?
Really?
That's...
Is that different?
That's slightly different. I don't know if that's like an alternate text or...
Maybe it's just alternate.
It might be.
Turn that guy off.
Right.
Save power.
Yeah. Come on,
that
guys.
That coworker's not coming back for it.
Here we go.
All right.
What does turning off the computers do?
I don't know.
Oh, it's back to zero.
Shoot. All right.
It looks like you have to hit it 4 times.
Yeah. Okay.
The meeting room. Do we know what the meeting room is? We've been into, like, the break room.
Yeah.
Well, I've never really been into a meeting room.
No, the meeting room's the one with the big boards.
Oh,
yeah.
That's right. we want to take the... Here.
I think we go right this time.
Really? I think we go left.
And then do what?
And then we came to a
we
set
try
of
to
two
take control
doors.
Over everyone.
He entered
we do...
the door on his
oh,
power on.
Okay. All right, all right. We do like a... It's like a genocide run.
Yeah, it's a gen... Well, it's a...
The mind control run. Do. Oh, I want to try putting 8888 into the.
Oh, we can do that
too.
That's perfect.
All right, cool. Disbelief. Oh shoot! Stanley people want us to go back to the window. To darn it. Office. There's then they. Everyone keeps saying there's something
Stanley
at the window.
Walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Well, we'll do the 888, and we're. I'm gonna try to take control over everyone's mind today.
Right.
In,
okay.
Or in this run.
Stepping into his manager's office. Stanley
and some people
was
are saying there's no vent.
To
so
not
we'll
an indication of any human life.
We saw it on a map. We saw it on a map yesterday.
Stanley wondered aloud to nobody.
Okay.
All right.
He began
so
tearing
all
through
this?
Papers on the boss's desk,
what if
pulling
you type
books
the code
off the shelf,
he gets
looking
to
behind
the
paintings.
Yeah, I'm also wondering what happens then.
Desperate for clues to his situation.
Wait, sorry, one sec.
But his attention was caught by a keypad behind the boss's desk. What could its purpose be? In fact, this keypad guarded the terrible secret that lay buried below his feet.
It's interesting how
so
it's slightly different.
It is.
An extra
it's weird.
PIN number.
I wonder if it's based on the last scenario you did, or...
It might be.
Of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this.
So, what, did you guys say that you were curious
8888.
Yeah, we'll do 888.
Stanley just sat around twiddling his thumbs. Trying to input anything on
what?
The device was useless, since he could never possibly know that the combination
the chat
was
like
two,
really
eight,
adamant
four,
about
five.
This.
8888.
Eight.
Stanley simply began entering random codes into the keypad.
Achievement unlocked!
Full well,
yeah!
Okay.
Five.
Weird. All right.
I'm just gonna keep doing it.
Okay, let's see. Oh, David Gossert says he does acknowledge it if you enter the number before he says it. 8888.
Oh,
good, we got that achievement.
Forgot,
someone said, oh, you can crouch and jump out a window, someone says. I don't, Luke Crumb
and
said that.
The door just opened all by itself.
911,
and
what about 666?
And Stanley got along with the story. Well, whoop-de-doo.
Nope, no 666
okay.
either. All right, fine.
All right. Jill S. says, broom closet ending, mate. Yeah,
we fell for that one yesterday.
Yeah,
we got the broom closet ending. It was the best ending so far.
It was my favorite.
It was the best. It was incredible. I was blown away. The graphical fidelity of that broom closet was just through the roof. It was. It really like brought tears to my eyes.
It was emotional. I, thinking back on it, I'm getting a little verklempt.
You know how you have those moments in your like gamer history that. Will just stay
Stanley
with you forever.
Straight ahead through
the
large the
broom
door,
closet
the red
ending.
Mind control
right up there
facility.
With the ending
really
of Earthbound
yeah.
and Mother 3. Oof. Powerful stuff, man. Powerful stuff.
Fabler the First says in the beginner room. I think it's the window that people are talking about is in one of the first rooms.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place
Rockert
hold?
Rockert Ken says,
Stanley
keep going to the broom
himself.
Closet, it gets
did he
better.
Have the strength to find out?
We went to the broom closet a lot of times.
I mean, we could go in repeated scenarios if we wanted to.
That's true. Yeah, because the narrator...
The narrator remembers.
Now the
seems
monitors
to.
Jump to life.
Depending on the scenario.
Yeah.
Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals
see, there's my
reduced to
yeah,
images on
I know.
A screen. And Stanley, one of them.
I think it's that yellow thing, or it's not shown.
It's too high. It's it would be in the corner, but it's unfortunate that like, it's unfortunate that there isn't anything that you can do with that information, especially when they've gone to the trouble of numbering everything, and you can see like which one is yours, right? This is one of those games that something like this would be really significant. It feels like.
Oh yeah.
And so like, oh, there's a camera. I can dismantle the wall and find the camera. And whatever, but
right? I thought,
alas,
yeah.
Twas not to be this time. Twas not to be, game!
Facility. It was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true.
So that I'm gonna take control over everyone's mind this time.
Cool.
All this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Jerry Baker says, are we not all trapped in a broom closet in one way or another?
No.
Wow. That was deep.
He
that was deep.
To
clap and
it.
Half for that.
He couldn't accept
that
it.
That was beautiful.
His own life
amazing.
In someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable.
Never.
Wasn't it? Was it even possible?
David Gossard says, hey, they will do extra things the more times you go to, the world. To each place.
But here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this
place.
And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
The buttons have to do something.
Right.
This is a game where the buttons got to do something, right?
Yeah.
They got to. I'm going to do 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Just.
No.
Why not?
All right.
I'm trying, Steph. Something new. There are secrets. There are secrets beheld in this place.
Q-Man the Gamer says, you'll die automatically, but doesn't say what will kill us automatically.
Everything. Everything in this game. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Let's see. Fireblaze says, code to your right.
2. Hmm. Nothing. There's got to be another.
Anya Elise says, while there might not be an actual broom closet ending, it is a wonderful place to stay for eternity.
The cultish levels of enthusiasm that some of you had for this broom closet.
I know, for broom closet.
Very concerning to me. All hail broom closet.
Pledge your allegiance to broom closet.
Must join broom closet. We are all one in the broom closet. The room's he has not joined broom closet. Let's give him a controlled shock.
His obligation. To put an end to this horrible place and to everything it stood for.
On. There we go.
Oh, Stanley, you didn't just activate the controls, did you?
I didn't.
Powermongers!
All these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted?
Yes!
Control?
Yes! Control!
Stanley, I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go, turn the controls off, and leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that.
I'm afraid you don't have
nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system.
Oh boy!
In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification.
Whoops.
Nuclear detonators are set to explode.
Oh no!
Oh no!
Entire complex. How long until detonation then? Let's say 2 minutes.
Go!
Ah, now this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Steph?
It is!
Yeah!
Your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now.
Sweet!
Shape it to your heart's desires.
No.
Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind.
Okay.
A shame we have so
we have to hit the code. I'm sure,
Real
right?
Moments until
to deactivate
the bomb
it or something?
Off. But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you, about me, where we're going, what all this means.
Oh,
I barely know where to start. What's that?
Huh.
You'd like to know where your co-workers are? A moment of solace before you're obliterated?
No.
All right. Okay.
He's gonna tell me what happened to my coworkers.
I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story.
Huh.
Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone.
Other times,
I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing
the buttons.
Everyone inside, or I let it burn to a crisp. I have to say this.
Try the numbers.
This has been rather amusing.
Yeah, 3.
Watching you try to make sense of everything.
Try it. No, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Try it now.
Rested away from you.
No, it's quite rich. It says 3 on here.
I must hate
3?
To see it go.
3.
But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go
around where does it say 3?
Will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm
3.
Enjoying this so much.
Blue 3.
You know
3.
What? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock. Why not? These are precious additional seconds. Time doesn't grow on trees.
What
am I supposed to do?
What's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now? Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off?
Wait.
Look at you, running from button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room.
The two.
These numbered buttons. No, these colored ones.
But you have to get the two.
This big red button, or this door. Everything, anything.
What are you doing?
I'm hitting the red button twice!
No, it's a pink button and you have to hit the two!
Listen to him, Stephanie! He's telling us that it's pointless! He's saying that we should just embrace the cool! Brace
but
of
we
death.
Don't have to do what he says! You don't get
it's
it!
Fine! Blow me up!
Quite a disappointment.
If we're doing the run out the clock playthrough, tell me we're doing the run out the clock playthrough. Otherwise, I don't know why you're running around hitting the wrong buttons.
You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you.
Seriously,
seriously,
hit something more useful. Are you doing the run out the clock?
I'm listening to him! Let me either listen to him or play the f***ing game!
You wanted to control this world, that's fine.
Apologies, Mr.
I'm going to destroy it first, so you can't.
Oh, man.
Take a look at the clock, Stanley.
I don't see you coming up with good ideas, Steph.
I told you to hit the buttons in order again.
Where? Why would I do that?
All the
number
buttons.
That has no point. It has no point. Why? Why would I hit the buttons in order?
It has just as much point as whatever you're doing.
I had buttons with colors and numbers on them.
But you weren't hitting the right colors.
I was. It was red. Do you see a pink button anywhere?
Maybe.
Do you see a pink button anywhere? No, you do not. Show me the pink button.
Until the moment I say, happily ever after.
Look around some more.
Good.
All right,
thank you.
Did
you for blowing me up.
Clap and a half for that?
There are no claps and halves in that.
I don't know why you wouldn't try and save yourself.
What do you think I was doing? What do you think I was... Why are you hitting the... I was hitting the red button twice. I was hitting the three button. Did you not see? There was a blue button with a three on it. So I hit the three button. I hit a blue button. I tried hitting the blue button three times. I tried hitting the red button twice. I tried hitting the two. Where in that whole scenario would you have thought that me hitting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 wouldn't have been helpful at all?
Because there are five buttons and you can try it. If you, those three things you just described there, the hitting the three button three times and the blue button three times.
And so instead,
That takes like 30 seconds of experimentation.
So instead,
if it doesn't work, you try something else.
So instead of me trying to solve the problem the way I thought, using the clues that were being provided for me in the game itself.
You also never said what you were doing.
Because I was also trying to listen to the narrator who was saying all sorts of stuff. Well,
He's just trying to distract you from trying to solve the puzzle.
Sure, maybe, but at least then I would understand that part of the ending and I would be set. But now I neither got the blow up ending nor did I get the save myself
you
ending.
You have to listen instead, to your heart and not the narrator.
Instead, I got the ending where I had me, and me trying to do stuff and the whole thing, and I swore and I felt bad for swearing.
You should.
I do. I feel bad for swearing.
Here you see gamers in their natural habitat.
Be quiet, Jason. No one gave you that microphone.
Says Mr. Overwatch over there.
He'll keep up that good momentum.
What did we learn from that ending?
He never functioned well by himself and constantly needed support and guidance from others. So the thought
did we really learn the value of teamwork?
Makes the dream work.
Here. Input. There. Input received. Good.
Should I give you a nice clap on the back for that one? Commend you?
I don't know why you're salty.
When Stanley came to a set of two open
screw
doors,
you,
this
game.
Was not the correct
what, you're not going to go back and try
and
it?
Stanley knew it perfectly well.
Should you go back and try again? To try and disarm the nuclear bomb that's in the basement? There's a nuclear bomb in the basement.
It had really been worth the detour after all.
Yes. Where's the vent?
To spend a few moments here in this
where's the vent?
Beautifully constructed room. Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in.
They say there's a vent in this room.
There's no vent.
The vent is a lie! Just like
lie.
The cake! The vent and the cake are a lie!
I think it was an early prototype or something.
Really, really worth it being here in the room.
Let's move on. There is still a nuclear bomb in the basement.
Stanley
just
took
saying.
The first open door on his left.
Here, I'm taking the first open door on my left. Here we go.
And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
Huh. Go, oh, whatever happens if you go down the elevator. No. Now we're just back in the other area. Ah! Maybe this will take us to the nuclear bomb, which we can try and disarm again.
But Stanley didn't want to go back to the office. He wanted to wander about and get even further off track.
All right, so the chat is going crazy right now. I also wanted to say, I don't know whether to look at it because I would love it if we could figure it out on our own. So I'm going to hold out for a couple more minutes so we don't spoil, that ending because I want us to try it again.
What if I don't want to go left? What if I don't want to listen to the narrator and I don't want to go left?
There are only so many doors in the game, man.
Apparently none of them are opening up, so...
Oh, no. Whoa. No, it's to the right, my mistake.
Oh!
Oh, cute!
No, no, not the right. Why would I have ever said it was to the right? What was
I
thinking?
We're trapped in this little game!
Oh, dear, would you hold on for a minute, please?
What?
Now, let's see.
Come on, narrator.
Right, left, down, left, right.
AB start! Yep. Okay. Up, down, left, right, AB start.
I've got it now. This story is absolutely, definitely this way.
What?
Ooh, hello.
I don't know.
Can I still disobey him or no? I guess I'm still stuck.
Shoot.
That's all right. It's all right. It's another ending. It's a new experience, Steph.
Yeah, you know what else is a new experience? Disarming the nuclear bomb in the basement.
You know what's a new experience? Actually knowing how to disarm the damn bomb.
You know how you get the experience you need in a
by
game?
By not listening to you.
By practicing and trying again.
Why sure, by using context clues that the game provides you in order to solve the puzzle.
By taking Jason's microphone away from him so we can stop making snarky remarks behind our back.
Yeah, what are you saying, Jason?
I said, why is everyone whispering?
Here's a whisper for you.
Screw you, Jason.
That was especially for you.
Hashtag blame Jason.
All right, play the game. Play it.
No, apparently. See, again, to the point of Stanley Parable, I want to play the game my way. I want to go through it. I want to experience. No, I got to play it this way.
Teamwork.
I got to play it the way that it's been demanded of me, apparently. Right? So who's really in control, ladies and gentlemen of GT Live, I present to you? Who is really in control?
I think they all know that already.
They are, actually. They know that they're in control. If we were playing Undertale and we, like, mm-hmm. killed Goat Mom or whatever, we would never be able to live it down. Toriel would be...
Never. Right? Never.
It's true. All right, fine. We're moving on.
Are you saying you've killed Goat Mom before?
You gotta do a genocide run somehow?
Are you saying you've done the unthinkable?
No. This isn't right at all. You're not supposed to be here yet. This is all a spoiler. Quick, Stanley, close your eyes.
It's a spoiler!
Okay. We just have to get back
Who am I kidding? Fired.
It's all rubbish now. The whole story completely unusable.
Aww.
Rather than waste my time trying to salvage this nonsense, we'll just restart the game from the beginning. And this time, suppose we don't wander so far off track, hmm? Okay, from the top.
What?
Really? Is that... that's not the end of this
I
one.
I think you go back there again.
I think you do this again a couple times.
All of his co-workers were gone.
People what want us through the window.
Stanley decided
I want to continue
Perhaps
with this one.
All right. Again. And continue inputting as well.
I didn't play the game the way he wants to.
No one. I have no control. I am just a puppet for the desires of other. Shoot, where's the?
You're the puppet?
I am. I am the marionette. I give gifts and give entertainment while other people tell me what controls to input in. That is my life. I am just a mindless button pusher. Oh.
When Stanley. Wait. What? No, I restarted. I swear, I definitely restarted the game over, completely fresh. Everything should be. Oh, did something change? Stanley. Did you change anything when we were back in that room with all the monitors? Did you move the story somewhere or... Hold on. Why am I asking you? I'm the one who wrote the story. It was right here just a minute ago.
What?
I know for sure that it's here
This is
somewhere.
Not... What?
Didn't see this one
coming. Okay, then. It's an adventure.
Come, Stanley. Let's
there's more doors.
The story.
Go left, go left.
Oh man, there's so
many. Oh, there's so many doors.
There's so many doors.
Oh my gosh.
I want this door. You can go I want this door. Give me this door.
Oh my gosh, you're always. God. No pleasing you. All right.
Can you go to the left once you go through that door?
Yeah, like, I think that's what you can do.
Let's do it.
Join those two.
What? There are so many.
Oh yeah.
Oh man.
What do we got over here?
Oh man, this is so exciting.
Ooh, basement. Oh. Or storage area.
Just storage.
I'll say it. This is the worst adventure I've ever been on. I can promise you there definitely was a story here before. Do we need to restart the game again?
No!
Let me explore!
I find it that we'll ever progress by starting over and over again, but it's gotta be better than this.
No!
Okay, let's give it a shot.
No!
Gosh!
Darn it! Wait, okay.
All of his co-workers were gone.
What
could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Oh, I thought that said meme for a second.
He went to the meme room!
He went to the meeting room. He thought he just missed a meme.
He went to the meme room. He saw Nyan Cat. Hung out with Harambe. Ah, yes, the classic meme room. Ah!
Okay, it's worse. I might be remembering this wrong. It's possible the story
biggest
is
troll
back
game ever.
Where we just came from. Why don't we go back the other direction and see if we missed anything?
Ooh.
What?
Did I miss anything? All right. Nope.
Huh.
Nope. I want something, like, completely absurd to pop out.
Right?
Oh, hey.
There you go.
Found it.
Right? That was so weird.
Kooky crazy. I want it to be like Day Shift at Freddy's, where now all of a sudden something completely random and unrelated just shows up in the middle of the frame.
And suddenly this becomes mirror layers where we just turn around.
I knew we'd miss something. The story. Here it comes.
Doc.
Ooh, hello. Here comes the story.
No, wait, never mind. Not the story. Okay, let's head back the other way and retrace our steps.
Aw, come on, man. He's just trolling us now.
Oh, we're going in circles.
Oh.
Oh, okay, this is different. All right.
Now this, well, I'll be honest, I don't recognize this place at all. Is this the story? I don't think so. I can't quite recall, but I believe my story took place in an office building. Is that correct? Do you remember, Stanley?
It is correct. It is correct, narrator.
Yes, you got it, dude.
Since I've completely forgotten what we were supposed to be doing, how about this? You win!
Congratulations!
I know you put in a lot of hard work, and it really paid off. So, good job.
Yeah, this narrator's really doing a bang-up job, Matthew. I'm so
best
glad.
Best ending!
I'm so glad you want to just pay so much attention to him rather than talking to the person next to
him. He's talking.
Some people win fair and square, and this was not one of those situations.
It's okay. It's okay. Breathe through the nose.
I'm getting weirded out by whatever this place is. I don't care what might happen this time. I have to restart.
Gross.
Got your, like, girl words on me. Ah! Adventure line!
Great.
Sally Parable Adventure line.
All right.
Line.
I've got a solution.
This is great.
This time, to make sure we don't get lost, I've employed the help of the Stanley Parable Adventure Line.
Sweet!
Just follow the line. How simple is that?
Does that help you? Does that help you solve the problem better, Matthew?
It does, thank you.
Does that help?
It's very helpful.
I'm glad the narrator could assist.
It's deepening my enjoyment of the game tenfold, Steph, okay?
Wow.
We're going to a different room this time.
Oh, man.
Still turn off all my computer monitors.
Right?
It is a tradition. You always turn off your computer monitors.
There you go. Nice.
Yeah, I'm on it. I want to go this way, though.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to follow the Stanley Parable Adventure line.
It seems like the kind of thing that you would do.
Yeah.
Follow the totally pre-prescribed path to the endpoint. And then get frustrated if you don't have one to follow.
It's over in this direction. Onward, Stanley.
Use the clues in the game.
Shh.
You play the game.
Wouldn't wherever we end up be our destination, even if there's no story there? Or to put it another way, is the story of no destination still a story? Simply by the act of moving forward, are we implying a journey such that a destination is inevitably conjured into being via the very manifestation of the nature of life itself? Okay, Stanley, I need to follow this train of thought for a minute. Just stick with me. Now, we can both agree that the nature of existence is in fact a byproduct
of one subjective experience of that existence, right?
Oh man, we're getting
okay. Now, if my experience of your existence rests inside of your subjective experience of this office, is this office, in fact, the skeleton of my own relative experiential mental subjective construct? Whoa. Hang on. That got a bit weird back there. Well, I'd like to apologize. Not sure where I was going with all that.
Oh, all right.
I think what we need right
now on a countdown.
Is a bit of music to lighten the mood.
Six.
I find this music totally fitting to the situation at hand.
Oh, now you want to veer off course?
This is so epic. See, Steph? You were trying to get me to not follow the line. Look at how fun this is. Look at this fantastic music that we would have missed out on.
Look at this exceptional gameplay.
Better than a lot of the games we play, Steph. Let's be honest. Would you rather?
Whoa. Oh, man. No penny corners now.
I'm not. Thank
that
you.
That wouldn't be like Stanley.
Employee 432 peer review.
Oh, man. Oh, what? Man, stay with it. Stay with it. It's
cut
getting tricky now.
Wait, go back and look at that fern.
Go back.
All right, let's look at that fern.
Look at the fern,
Stanley,
man.
This fern will be very important later in the story. Make sure you study it closely and remember it carefully. You won't want to miss anything.
See, Steph,
he's talking.
Are you looking
he's
at
talking.
The fern?
Are you looking at the fern?
Well, I am. Because I'm paying attention to what the narrator's telling. Pay attention to the fern. Have you looked at the fern, Steph?
I know that fern like I know my own face.
All right, then. How many branches are on that fern? Visible branches are on the fern.
52.
There is around 21 to 25 branches
You're
on the
You're missing
fern.
All the background branches.
That is grass. That is supplemental grass to the fern. We're talking about individual branches the fern. Individual branches containing leaves to the fern.
Those are fronds. Those are early fronds.
Okay, then how many fronds are there to the fern, miss? I have a photographic memory to the fronds and the fern. Fern fronds.
Wait, which ones are you talking about? Are you talking about the straight fronds in the back or the curly fronds in the front?
I'm talking about total fronds in the fern, friend.
Are you talking about the full
how
fronds?
How many fronds are in the fern, friend?
22.
Oh. Uh-huh. Yeah, you're welcome for giving you that answer.
I already knew.
Jason's like, there's zero fronds in the fern because they're actually... ferns don't have fronds. Isn't that right, Jason?
You said branches. I said zero.
You can't expect him ferns to know these things.
How many rides are in Disneyland? Zero. They're all adventures.
There's one ride, actually.
I know. It's Mr. Toad's Wild
Mr.
Ride.
Mr. Toad's Wild Ride.
It's a thing that they tell you at Disneyland. There's one ride in Disneyland. It's Mr. Toad's Wild Ride. All the rest of them are... what is it?
Not attractions.
Attractions.
Oh, yeah.
Attractions.
So, true right, story, if you want a confusing trivia question for your friends, ask them how many rides are at Disneyland.
Troll.
Oh, it's a total troll. But it's true.
But
if you look it up on the
say.
Disneyland website, they'll tell you that there is one ride and everything else is an attraction.
Lyme, you do know we're looking for the Stanley Parable, right? The story? Is any of this ringing a bell?
Here we go.
Man, you've just taken to blindly following, not even trying.
There we go, we made it back, see? Look.
No, not again, Lyme. How could you have done this to us?
And we wanted to get back here and we did.
After everything we've been through, you... Oh, I can't take
Thank
this
you.
Anymore. To hell with it. Restart.
Yeah, great. That got you far.
Yep, clap it out for me.
You know what would have been a really cool ending? The one where we defuse the nuclear bomb in the basement.
You know what?
Yeah, you know what would have been great? Knowing how to do that. Instead of making blind and random guesses.
Why can't we make up our own story?
Well, look, we're making up our own
story. Exciting, daring, mysterious.
Ooh.
This all sounds perfectly doable. Why don't we simply start wandering in, well, I don't know. How about this direction?
Great.
Cool. Let's do it.
You and the narrator just continuing on your love
story. I'm having a great time with this ending.
Yes,
thank you, Steph.
I'm so glad
exciting.
You two are getting along
just
so well.
Stanley
I don't feel like a third wheel at all.
Just me and Stanley forging a new path.
What do you want our story to be? Go wild. Use your imagination. Whatever it might be, Stanley,
I'm ready for it.
Yes, let's do it. You and me, narrator. Just the two of us. Just you and me, buddy. Oh, look, I'm going to go backwards now. I'm going to go forwards.
I don't know. Your narrator lover didn't tell you to do that.
We're in a synergistic relationship, Steph. He supports me. I support him.
Stanley, I'd also like to veto the line from having any role in our awesome new story. No lines or monitor rooms.
Yeah.
Just don't acknowledge it. We should be fine.
We're fine, narrator. You and me, going through this blank, empty hallway together.
He seems really sure about what's going on right here.
You know what? Just because he's unsure about what's going on, I support him as his friend and companion in this game.
As his companion cube?
As someone who is invested in him as a partner, I support him in his decisions to try and figure out the clues in the game to defuse the nuclear bomb.
I don't think he's going to help you defuse that nuclear bomb. He kind of let you die before.
Yeah, and I would have loved to have heard what he was saying while he was letting me die, so I could have fully felt satisfied from that ending, Steph.
How are these hallways looking?
Great. I'm having a great time.
You seem like you're doing real well.
I'm doing phenomenally, Steph. Look at how good I'm doing.
You do. You seem like you're doing just bang-up work there, bud.
Thank you. Thank you.
That yellow line. You're not even letting it get in your way. Not even a little bit.
Not even trying to follow it, Steph.
No,
nope.
You don't even care.
Boom,
even
I'm care off the yellow there. Line. Look where I am now.
It's not affecting your adventure.
Choice. Here we go.
We get to make a decision. From here, the story is in our control.
Mm.
How important, we mustn't squander the opportunity.
Mm-hmm. So true.
In fact, I believe I need a minute to think here. Just walk in circles for a minute.
Okay.
Done. So I know that each door has to lead somewhere. Which means that somewhere, the place where we're trying to go, there must be a reverse door that leads here. And that, in turn, means that our destination corresponds with the counter-inverted reverse door.
See, look,
seems like a super efficient partnership.
Look how smart he is, Steph.
Let us ask, will taking the right door lead us to where we're going?
Right? That is a good, astute question, narrator.
Brilliant. Brilliant work going on there.
The door on the right is the correct one. Another victory for logic. Come, Stanley. Our destiny awaits.
Look. Boom. Here we go. He's so smart.
Are you ready?
Oh, hold up. What's this? The confusion ending. You're telling me that's what this is? It's all one giant ending? And we're supposed to restart the game eight times?
Oh, eight times. Narrator
for really how all this goes? It's all determined?
Oh, determinism!
So
see,
now, according to the schedule, I restart again.
Yeah.
Am I just supposed to
remember
forget?
Remember I said this is a parable for determinism
yesterday? What if I
don't
want to forget? My mind goes blank simply because it's written here on this thing, wall.
Ooh, after a long time, the narrator
well,
died.
Who consulted me?
Oh.
Why don't I get to decide? Why don't I get a say in all of this? Is it really... No, it can't be. I don't want it to be. I don't want the game to keep restarting. I don't want to forget what's going on. I don't want to be trapped like this. I won't restart the game. I won't do it. I won't do it. I won't do it. And the time return stopped? Does that mean, did we do it? Did we break the cycle? The, whatever it is that made this schedule? How would we even know?
Can I return to the office?
Will someone come for us?
Okay.
Will something happen?
Narrator restarts the game. He's not.
Okay.
Find the confusion ending schedule.
I guess
he'll
now
restart
just
the game.
You know.
Right, so he should
he'll restart it, and he'll forget about the previous restart.
Story.
Then
wouldn't
what happens?
Agree? I'm not quite sure if we're in the destination
Vincent,
or the journey. Though they're always saying that life
okay.
is about the journey
oh,
and
the
not
again.
The destination. So I hope that's where we are right
you're
now. We'll find out.
He's going to forget. I'm just saying he's going to forget all of your love.
Well, in the meantime...
Shoot, we didn't get to finish reading the end. Stanley eventually dies at the end.
Well, okay, so everything looks the same. He forgets about the previous restarts.
Yep.
But we're going to be prevented in some way,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, we're going to be prevented from playing the game.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Okay. We're going to do it.
All right, this one we should be prevented from playing almost entirely.
I see how interested you are in this ending now, Stephanie. Welcome to the confusion ending.
Mm.
Isn't that exciting?
It is for me. I don't know what you and the narrator are doing. You're probably still off in a back room making out somewhere.
We're having a great
Stanley
time.
Came to a set of two open doors. He entered the door
on his
left.
It doesn't like being prevented from playing the game, though.
Right? Where am I being prevented? Should I follow him?
Let's go left.
Am I going to be prevented from playing?
Yet there was not a single person here either. Ooh. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office.
Shoot.
Is it not
he
true?
Might find an answer there.
It's...
Coming to a staircase,
he restarted
Stanley walked
it.
Upstairs
he did, just
to
like
his
it said,
office.
And he forgot about the other endings.
Right, but now I'm not being prevented from playing. That's weird. Was that really the ending? It seems like it wasn't.
No, yeah, it seems like...
Huh.
The moment
right, well,
he entered his manager's office, Stanley froze in his tracks. Not a living soul anywhere. Could he really be all alone?
We should also type in the real code.
This was too much for Stanley to take. Too much for any man to take. He fell to... Stanley was in such a rush to get through the story as quickly as possible, he didn't even have a single minute to just let the narrator talk.
The narrator!
That kind of anxiety isn't healthy, so he relaxed for a few moments with some calming age music.
Slow jam! Huh. Me and the narrator, slow jam!
Alright!
It's alright. I'm okay with this.
You and the narrator, man.
That's right, Steph. It's February.
Feeling soothed and rejuvenated,
me and the narrator.
Stanley calmly walked forward into the opened passageway.
Matthew Hart, narrator.
Yeah, keep playing.
Well, you can be happy because now we're going to get to defuse the bomb again.
I know, that's where I was... hoping this would inevitably lead.
Well, aren't we all happy that the deterministic future went to Steph? Hey, you know, instead of being Salt Steph over there, instead of being Salt Steph, maybe you should hop into Twitter or the chat or something.
It's Steffy Salt, and I didn't want to ruin it before. Okay.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
While we get back to that.
Koki Agosto says, slow dance. Scott Carter says, go to the cargo lift ending.
Room packed with television screens.
Never mind.
What horrible secret did this
place hold? The cargo lift ending is when you take a right, I think.
I don't really know. This is why it's called the confusion ending. I ship narrator, Pat, says, Odriel W.
Looking at you, narrator.
Let's see. Anime Weirdo says, so graceful. Death Gamer says, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Matthew Vidal says, jealous much, Steph? I know. This narrator. Let's see. One of them. Hannah Amsler says, you can't. The Woods Gaming says, the window, like so many before. Woods Gamer have also said the window. We're gonna have to do the window.
To the wall!
Gamer Girl 14 says OTP, you a narrator. Let's see.
Been under someone's control all this time?
Cookie Cat says you can't disarm the bomb.
Well, look at that.
Spookie Pineapple also says you can't defuse the bomb.
Well, look at the chat. Probably having foreknowledge of the game that we're trying to play.
Probably. Jeremy Tawari says, no, disable the bomb, not possible. Oh, man.
Oh, well, that's three for three in the chat.
It was unthinkable.
I'm glad
it. Wasn't it?
I'm glad that.
Had it truly
that I trust the loyal viewers of GT Live, the loyal theorists?
I do too.
Clap and a half to them.
At least I had the determination to come back and try again when I thought it was possible.
Oh, I would come back as well.
Given up.
I would come back as well. At least I have the gaming fortitude to try and use the context clues provided to me by the game.
Let's see. You have to stand on the desk to get to the window, says Caleb Malls. You actually can't defuse the bomb. All right, so we can't defuse the bomb.
Well, I guess we get to enjoy
this
ending.
Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power.
That's weird that none of the buttons mean anything.
Do you want to try the off ending?
For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
No, I don't think we're prevented from anything.
The off ending's gonna go off.
Oh, Stanley.
It's weird.
You didn't just activate the controls, did you? After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted? Control? Stanley,
here, once the countdown starts,
I applaud your effort, I really do.
I'll try counting up on the number of hands.
I don't think, I mean, so it, most people in the chat are just saying it's not possible.
Steph, since when are you dissuaded from doing something
if
like
you
that?
Want to throw
when the chat says it, because they're always right.
Much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the
Let's
power
see.
You think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated
press the off
the
button when you just push
emergency
the on
detonation
button.
System. Hmm. In the event that this machine is activated
Let's
without
see.
Proper DNA identification, nuclear detonators
ZZ Blast says, get the Shrek swamp ending. I am curious about that one.
I have a feeling that one doesn't work.
Moon Scarline says, the code's 12345, but I don't... I'm also seeing people say that it's not possible.
A little more fun, isn't it, Stanley?
Go,
it's your time to shine.
One,
you
two,
are the star. It's your story
two.
Now. Shape it to your heart's desire.
We're gonna try.
Oh,
we're gonna try.
Right.
Look,
okay.
There's a yellow button, Steph. Tell me when you see a yellow
so
button.
Okay. Time
okay.
Left to enjoy it.
Since you were so adamant about
the
color the of the button.
Goes off.
Do you want to just that? There was a yellow button back there.
Is. More time to talk about you.
There was a yellow
was
button
there,
right
Was
right
there
here.
Really a yellow button?
Yeah, it was actually right there on the console. Okay, go ahead and do that. I think that's a good idea. Four.
You'd like to know where your co-workers
Here,
are.
Also, let's listen to him.
A moment of solace before you're obliterated. All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever,
you
pushing buttons
remaining.
Endlessly and then dying alone.
Huh,
you have three
weird.
Attempts remaining.
Other times, I let the office sink into
Pretty
the
weird.
Ground,
right?
swallowing everyone inside,
ten.
Or I let it burn to a crisp.
Ten.
I have to say this, though. This version
ten?
Of events
the
has been
button.
Rather
oh,
amusing.
Okay. Oh,
watching you try to make
eight.
Sense of everything and take
weird.
Back the control wrested away from
Smart.
You, it's quite rich. I almost
yellow
hate
button.
To see it
huh,
go. But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm
Let's
enjoying
see.
This so much.
I'm going to try and read some
you
stuff in the
what?
Chat.
To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock. Why not?
Incorrect.
These are precious additional
Back
seconds.
Out of the boss's room before the
time
door is closed. It's possible. This leads to a new ending.
Oh dear me, what's the matter, Stanley?
Back out of the boss's
Is it that
room
you have
the...
no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now? Or
they
did
say
you
can back out of the boss's room before
that
the door
timer,
closes.
That something
so you
in
can
this
get
room
out of...
was capable
Steph,
of turning
the
it on.
Room. This is the...
It isn't?
Look at you. Running from
Red
button
two.
To button.
Oh, the boss's...
Screen
oh,
to
they
screen,
mean like the boss's office.
On
I was thinking this is like the boss room.
These numbered buttons.
Yep.
No,
re-enter the password.
Or maybe this big red button. Or this door. Everything, anything, something here will save me.
See, he's saying that.
Why would you think that, Stanley? That this video game can be beaten? Won? Sold? Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is? But you really believe there's an answer? How many times will you replay this bit, looking desperately for a solution?
See, that...
10? 100? 1,000?
Looking desperately for
I look forward to finding out and to watching the bomb go off each time you
yeah,
fail.
Yeah, they just say it.
Just you
it
and
can
me
be done.
In a retching
huh.
explosion of fire and metal over and
Someone
over and over for all of eternity.
The phone,
and
really
Stanley died again. And Stanley died again. And Stanley died again. Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds you have left to struggle. 30 seconds until a big boom and then nothing. No ending here. Just you being blown to pieces.
Big red button, is there a door? I don't know. There's just a lot. There doesn't seem to be a conclusive suggestion here.
Make it count. Or don't. It's all the same to me. All a part of the joke. And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable life from the moment we fade in until the moment I say...
Just unsatisfying, you know?
It does seem like there's something that you can do there, right?
Or some other ending or something.
Because they are giving you clues, but I think that's the point of it, right? Is that you're given clues, but at the end, nothing that you do matters, right? Like, the whole point of this game is about determinism. And so,
right.
like, the fact that... You do or do not have, like, whether or not you do or do not have control over your actions and your fate in life, in the game, whatever.
Yeah.
And so there, the narrator's like, here's a bunch of things for you to interact with in this room, but, like, none of them will do anything.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, you're just gonna die.
Huh.
So I think that is the point.
Man, that's rough.
Right? I know. I am a bit just okay, so wait. Mm. So now everyone wants us to jump out a window. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Yeah.
How do I do this?
Okay, I'll wait for the chat to catch up. They've been very adamant about this. All right. They're really into the window. Climb on the desk.
Climb on the desk. I'm on a desk.
Okay. Oh, you are. You're on a desk. Apparently, it's possible to get out of a window from on top of one of the desks.
I am on a desk.
Okay.
I'm on a desk.
Stanley went around touching every
right,
little
which
thing
desk,
in the
which,
office.
Which desk it didn't is make it? A That's what we need difference. To know.
Nor did it advance the story in any way.
Did you get on that desk through the chair? Is that what allowed you to get
yeah,
up there?
Yeah,
it seemed to
let's
be.
Let's see. Window, yeah. Window,
so maybe
let's
look for
see.
Another desk with a chair like that?
Right, with a chair that's kind of like slightly pulled out from the desk.
Yeah.
Maybe see. It's another room.
Desk, 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 desk. All I'm seeing is desk and window.
Desk Hold and on. Window, not super helpful.
Desk 434.
430.
Do you see desk 434?
That was in that room, I think.
Yeah, that was back in the other room.
434.
Crouch. You have to.
Oh, you have to crouch.
There you go.
Oh.
Desk 434.
Come on.
Up on the
chair. Get on the desk.
There we go. 434. No. All right, and then crouch.
There you go. Okay, now
All right,
crouch.
Now crouch.
And do what?
Climb out the window.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. Hey.
Oh my gosh.
At first, Stanley assumed he'd broken the map. Until he heard this narration and realized it was part of the game's design all along.
That's amazing!
He praised the game for its insightful and witty commentary.
It was amazing!
So true.
Of video game structure and its examination of structural narrative tropes.
Hilarious!
So, now that you're here, what do you think? Isn't this a fun and unique place to be?
It is!
Why don't we take a minute just to drink it all in? Okay, I'm over it now. What do you think? Are you sick of this
Beautiful.
Gag?
No, I like this game. Ooh, ooh, hey, are you sick of this gag?
Say no.
I'm gonna say no, I like it.
Ah, then in that case, we'll continue. But now, here comes the real question. What do you think would have happened if you had told me that you wanted this to stop? Do you think it would have been particularly different? Would I have taken the same idea, but rephrased it superficially to fit that answer? Perhaps you never would even have thought of it if I hadn't brought up the issue in the first place. Oh. Now, think about it. Would it be worth it for you to restart and then come back here just to do the other option?
Absolutely.
Maybe this whole gag takes some time. What if the other option is even longer? How long would you spend in total just to have heard all the narration?
As long as it takes, narrator.
Yeah, narrator.
Perhaps you just played the other option, and now you've come to see what happens in this one.
Yep.
Yeah.
So, what do you think? Which choice was the better one? Imagine if you had selected continue on your first playthrough, how tantalizing it would be not knowing what happens when you pick the other option. Indeed, you are one of the lucky ones.
Thank you.
Though if the other option is really miserable to listen to, then perhaps you're not. In fact, I'm just going to say that no one who's listening to this is lucky. Well now, I've built up the other option so much that I'm going to stop talking and leave you to your decision whether to come back here, continue with the game, or just sit in this spot forever and ever. Cheers.
So basically what he's kind of alluding to is the fact, like, because that whole thing was generically done.
Oh, yeah.
And so it's always the other option and this mm-hmm. and that. So I bet if we say yes, he says the exact same
yep.
thing.
Yep. Uh-oh.
Is there no ending? Is there no ending? The fact that someone found this in the game.
Oh, it's great.
It must have been incredible for that person.
Oh, yeah.
How awesome would it have been to have been the person that is like, you know, who tries to break things and mm-hmm. try to figure out like, oh, I'm going to find the like edges of this game.
Oh, yeah.
And then you're like, yeah, suck on that Stanley Parable. Like, oh, I got on a desk. What do I do now? Oh, I snuck through the wall. And then just have the game recognize it. How awesome would that be?
It's amazing, actually.
That's
really cool.
Like, to be that person who was lucky enough to have that experience and, like, just discover it organically, that's incredible. I guess I gotta restart.
Yeah, I guess so. Shoot.
Do we do the other option?
Darn.
Or no?
I think it's gonna be exactly the same.
I think it's gonna be exactly the same as well. Wait.
Oh, someone said unplug the phone.
Phone.
Recorded message scheduled either by you or person in your place of work. The purpose of this message is to warn you about the dangers of recorded messages. If at any time you believe you are listening to a recorded message, please terminate it immediately and cease all flow of information from the recorded message into your perceptual sphere.
Stop.
Thank you.
Stop.
And have a pleasant day.
Stop. I tried. That was random and weird. That was weird and random.
Okay.
Does it have any effect on anything? Everything in this game makes me think it has some other purpose.
Right?
That there's going to be some way to, like, not break the game, but use the mechanics of the game in some different way.
I know.
It's a game that gets into your head, which is great, because it gets you to question literally everything that you're seeing.
Everything.
Everything. From glitches in the game to different graphical things to whatever. It's awesome. Ooh, be my Valentine. That's cute.
Maybe you can give it to the narrator.
Any other recorded messages?
Hmm.
Or something? It's such a random thing to have just had a recorded message and then. Weird. All right. Hold up. You'll notice that the narrator isn't here. He hasn't spoken yet. Usually he says something.
Really? He hasn't spoken at
and
all?
Remember, in the ninth playthrough, or in the next playthrough of the confusion ending, there's supposed to be no narrator.
No narrator. It's the second to last one, I think.
I thought it was second to last. Maybe I'm wrong. I should have paid more attention.
I know, I wish we had taken more time to read it. Shoot.
When Stanley came to set two open doors,
never mind.
He entered
just making it up!
Nah.
Let's go this way.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well.
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Employee lounge.
To business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
We did that one already.
Okay, we're gonna do something else.
It's interesting too because
at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
I'm gonna kill myself.
Okay, that's great. Just jump.
Thanks, Steph. Here we go.
Whoa!
But in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death.
Nailed
Good
it.
Good job, Stanley.
Thank you.
Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
New ending!
Behold me in my power! Are you impressed?
Way to go.
Have you not been impressed with my ability to control my
Stanley
destiny?
Stanley knew the office layout like the back of his hand. It was only a matter of time before he found the others, wherever they were. Just a matter of time.
Was it?
Speaking of a matter of time, it's a matter of time for me to find out where why does that input thing only show up every once in a while?
I don't get it. Yeah, why can't we get past two?
I know, that one bothers me.
It's another thing that I think it
might be just a troll.
Might be just a troll. Might be just like, you can't actually complete this. Here, let's go back that same way.
Stanley came to a set of two open doors. This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
I was sneaking for a second.
Stealth.
The lounge was sublime. A work of art.
Beautiful.
What was it about this room that called so but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
So that one's interesting because it's the confusion ending because you're indecisive,
yeah.
Right? You decided to disobey the narrator,
Stanley
then you
so
decide to follow
to go
him.
Back.
It's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Let's do this
one now. Okay. So we did one before where we jumped off
Stanley,
of this thing,
I think
but
right.
We've gotten off on the wrong.
And that
we're
going to
go all the way across.
That was the user survey ending.
It was.
I realize
and also
that investing
the one
your
with
trust
the babies
in someone
that Jason
else can
killed.
Be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing
because
but
he
you
had to pee.
All this time.
He couldn't hold his bladder.
There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley.
That's bad for you.
Someone
I have to pee a lot too.
About.
It's okay.
Please,
I'm
stop trying to make.
I'm no, I mean, I'm not trying to save
yourself.
Babies from burning in a fire
I'm
while I'm doing
for
it.
Me.
Right. I mean,
I'm asking for her.
Wait, what?
I'm asking for her.
For her?
This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself, to put your work aside, to let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
What do you want me to do, narrator? Who is this her?
What?
Who is this mysterious female figure in my life? Can I get to... I'm here.
That's so
Where
weird.
Is she? Where is she?
On the other side of that, like, room, we've never heard of her.
Ooh. Hello, dark room. All right, let's do it.
Plunge into the
depth. Into the breach.
That's her, Stanley.
You unplug need the to phone.
Unplug the phone. The chat was saying unplug the phone. At the phone.
If you can truly place your faith in another.
If you can truly place your faith in another, pick up the phone. I can't put my trust in anyone, narrator.
Unplug the phone.
Screw you!
Yeah.
As Stanley picked up the phone, a white light engulfed him, filling him not just with radiance, but with hope. Hope for a life reunited one...
Oh.
Wait. Oh, goodness. Stanley, did you just unplug the phone?
Damn straight!
No, yeah!
It wasn't supposed to be a choice. How did you do that?
Ah!
You actually chose incorrectly.
Boom!
Yes!
I didn't even know that was possible. Let me double check.
Oh, paper's rustling. Can I pick up the phone now?
No, it's definitely here, clear as day. Stanley picks up the phone. He's taken to his apartment where he finds his wife, and the two pledge themselves to one another.
Oh, what a nice way!
Nice way!
Dwight, roll
credits. Oh, I want to see that ending.
Not picking up the phone is actually somehow an incorrect course of action. How is that even possible?
Nope.
None of these decisions were supposed to mean anything. I don't understand. How on earth are you making meaningful choices?
Oh, I broke the air!
Wait a second. Did I just see? No, that's not possible. I can't believe it. How had I not noticed it sooner? You're not Stanley. You're a real person.
Ha
ha!
I can't believe I was so mistaken. This is why you've been able to make correct and incorrect choices.
Oh, they're correct.
I think I've been letting you run around in this game for so long. If you'd made any more wrong choices, you might have negated it entirely.
Oh,
it's
man.
It's as though you completely ignored even the most basic safety protocol for real-world decision-making. Or did you not grasp the severity of the situation? Well, I won't have that kind of risk on my watch. I'm going to stop the game for a moment so we can educate you properly on safe decision-making in the real world. Please observe this helpful instructional video.
What? No!
Oh,
It's the best part of being a real person. But if used incorrectly, it can also be the most dangerous.
Yes!
For example, in this scenario, a hypothetical real person named Stephen has a choice. He could spend years helping improve the quality of life for citizens of impoverished third world nations. Or he could systematically set fire to every orphan living in a 30-kilometer radius of his house.
What?
Which choice would you make? Remember that unlike here,
we know what
the real
choice Jason already
sense,
made today.
And at no time should you make a choice that does not conform to rational logic. If you find yourself speaking with a person who does not make sense, in all likelihood, that person is not real. Allow the person to finish their thought, then provide an excuse why you cannot continue talking. Turn to a partner and practice saying, "My goodness, is it 4:30? I'm supposed to be having a back sack and crack."
My goodness, it's 4:30. I'm supposed to be having a what?
Back sack
and crack? A back sack
Excellent.
And crack.
Making choices on a regular basis is
I appreciate
the best
that.
Part to a healthy
Continue
decision.
With your day.
Making
Enjoy process. Your back sack and crack.
Thank
Most
you.
Most medical
Goodbye.
Professionals recommend making at least 8 Thanks, choices God. Per day. Do you make more than 8?
Oh, less? Too many choices
so many.
And finally, if you begin to wonder if your choices are actually meaningful and whether you'll ever make a significant contribution to the world, just remember that in the vast infiniteness of space, your thoughts and problems are materially insignificant, and the feeling should subside. At this time, your instructor will guide you
Doesn't
in an
matter.
Exercise to
I'm just gonna,
test and
I'm just gonna hang out on the couch,
the
not do anything. My
video.
Choices don't matter.
It's a good couch.
Welcome Wait. Back. You may have noticed that this room has begun to deteriorate as a result of narrative contradiction. But not to worry. Now that you're properly informed on good decision-making, we're going to revisit a choice you made just a few minutes ago and see what the correct thing to do would have been. This way, please.
No, I want to unplug the phone again. Oh,
yeah.
Wait, no, the phone's still unplugged.
Pick up the phone?
Can you pick up the phone? Please.
Please,
wait,
I'm begging.
Please, I'm begging.
Stop, 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 stop.
Stop, stop,
More
stop.
Charts. What?
Weird. All right. Oh, this is exciting. Okay. So
yeah.
This is going back.
Yeah, what?
The way we came.
Boy.
Huh. Ha! And I can't jump off this time.
Huh.
Now that we know your choices are meaningful, we can't have you jumping off the platform and dying.
Oh, no!
Character dying senselessly halfway through the story. That story would make no sense at all.
What?
We just need to get you home as soon as possible before the narrative contradiction gets any worse.
Oh no, we've got to figure out how to get out of here.
Get out.
It seems this place is not well equipped to deal with reality.
What?
Oh, this is funny.
Oh man.
I can't jump through here.
Oh, there's nowhere to jump. Okay. We'll find something else to run off of.
Right? I will jump off of something.
Oh man.
Also weird that this key card is still a thing. Feels like there's something there because it's the only door that I've seen with a key card.
I know.
So confused. Wait. Use the safety scissors!
To do what?
Stab myself.
Oh. Do not lie if you're lying stuff right now. Okay. Let's see.
So we've unplugged the phone.
Almost there. You'll take the door on the left, back to the correct ending, the story will have resolution once again, and you'll be home free in the real world.
Go.
Okay.
Now remember, all you need to do is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Disobey?
I'm feeling pretty rebellious.
I can tell. Today you're in a very mm-hmm. She's even wearing her ripped jeans.
I know.
That's how rebellious she is
My
today.
Jeans have a hole in the knee right there.
How rebellious can you get?
Right?
She's wearing clothes, but those clothes are not fully intact.
I'm punky as all get out right now.
You calm yourself, little Missy.
Right? Right?
You calm down.
No! Why did you do that?
Oh, we're breaking it!
Hurry back in the other direction. Perhaps we're not too late.
Oh, we're breaking the game! No, I'm continue breaking it. This is super fun.
Huh. Oh, we can't?
Apparently not. We're just gonna continue breaking it, though. Okay. Break it again! No? No, maybe not?
No, I think that's it. Shoot.
No, I wanna keep breaking! Let me break the game!
Continue breaking! No!
Let me break, but not truly break the game.
Right.
All right, fine, we'll go left.
Hmm.
Now what?
Man.
Now what?
It's
ruined.
Broken.
I can't believe after everything we talked about that my story, you've destroyed my work.
Yes!
Oh, nice.
What did you get out of that?
Some men like to see the world burn.
So right?
It's me.
Stanley does.
Left here like so much garbage. It's worthless.
Tell the employees that everything is okay.
What am I supposed to do? Even if there were a way to continue, would it be worth it? To know that my story is now incorrect? How could I go back to that?
You gotta be able to get on the table. Through the chair?
I'll have to live with it forever. Reliving its impossibility forever. I couldn't live that way. Is it better to shut the game down entirely? To willingly destroy all of my work? No. What's the answer? What do I do? What do I do? What do I... No, I have to. I have to shut the game down.
No, don't do it!
I have to.
No!
I have to.
You don't have to.
What does the writing say? What does the writing say?
Oh no! Go,
run! No? Where are we? Do we get out?
Fight back, Stanley!
Come on, Stanley!
Your determination! Use your determination, yes! Oh my gosh, he's in the
too. I'm here. I'm still here. Here in this pile of rubbish. With you. You! Who thought you were so clever.
I am clever.
Now look where we are.
My
entire game is
destroyed.
Sounds
like you and narrator having a little lover.
It was the only thing in the world that was mine, and you run it into the ground.
He is not happy with you.
Did you think that would be funny? You just had to see? Didn't I impress upon you how important it was to be like Stanley? He actually knows how to do what I tell him to. He understands that if I say to do something, there's a damn good reason for it.
Oh, man!
That thought hadn't even occurred to you, had it? That there's a world outside of you? You're a child.
Oh, harsh.
Oh, man.
Harsh.
My story. If you'd just gone through the door on the left, you would have seen it. There was a whole underground facility. You would have destroyed it and been victorious.
Oh, man, that would have been fun.
Perfect. I worked so hard on it. I tried so hard. is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine.
Really?
All right.
Huh. Okay.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Yeah, should we do it? Or do we continue to disobey?
Keep going right.
I think we continue to disobey.
Yeah, I think we try it again.
No! Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry. Is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and
do it again.
The story oh, this is
first.
So weird and
I'm
funny.
Sure you'll be up to the task.
This is
just
great.
Follow
okay.
my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
No!
Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry.
Okay, it's starting to repeat now.
Is behave exactly as Stanley would.
Huh.
That means choosing responsibly.
So do you not have a choice here?
Putting it's, the story it's determinism.
First.
You
I'm quite sure you'll be
don't.
Up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine.
Yeah.
All right. When Stanley came to a set
or is it breaking
doors,
faster and faster each time?
No, it's it broke at the same time as it did last time. Do it one more time if you like.
All right,
on the right.
Let's do it one more time.
I think it breaks in the same
no!
point.
No! Why did yeah. you do that? Quickly, hurry up.
Yeah,
yep. it's
the
is same, that
it's same,
the same
place.
Okay.
Exactly
yep.
as
all right.
Would.
Okay. I guess we'll go left.
It's okay.
I guess we'll listen to him.
Putting the story
while you're working on going right or left. Sorry.
My lead and you'll be fine.
While you're working on going.
Is just so fixated on being rebellious.
Left. To a set of two open doors, I'll call out a couple things on Twitter.
You should.
At LumosNox123 says this game is actually super profound. I seriously love it.
I love this game.
Let's see. Danny Navarro at Omelette of Denmark says, this narrator would never kill the main character halfway through the story. Never. It's unthinkable. At DBZ, we 09, this sending is something. First things first, obey the narrator this time instead of going to the right. You might need to speak up.
Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Where's the broom closet? We can go back and
huh. There's no downstairs this time either.
Coming to a staircase, uh-huh. Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's
that's
office.
That's interesting.
There's nothing. That's
there's
interesting.
There's no choice.
There's no more choices. He's gotten rid
of
all my choices.
Oh, man.
The bathroom's gone, too.
Huh.
The executive
that's
bathroom's gone.
Oh, wow.
Or whatever. Right? That was the bathroom?
Yeah,
before?
That was the executive lounge bathroom, something?
Yeah, whatever it was. Huh.
Oh, we have an Easter egg to watch out for in one of our in one of the next ones. At Love to Read says, if you look while you pass the windows to the inner offices, you'll see a guy walking by the window. That's cool.
The boss's office is
ooh,
different now.
This is super weird.
How interesting is this?
Oh, cool.
Stepping inside his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief
what?
Who orchestrated
what
this,
this
until
stuff?
He saw the door with
aww.
A voice receiver
oh, it's
next
called
to
business
it.
Strategy.
Surely behind this door lay all the answers to his questions. And beyond all probability, he
wait.
Knew the passcode.
The passcode.
He had seen it on his boss's computer just huh. last week.
Night Shark.
Night Shark 115. Was this the code to open the door? Would it still work? There was only one way to find out.
That's weird.
Stanley had been trained never to speak up. But now, he would draw from huh. within himself the courage to face the unknown. He drew a sharp breath, and then spoke the code.
So there's sewage.
Night Shark 115.
Night Shark!
115!
Night Shark 115!
Nope.
Stanley spoke the code. Night Shark 115.
I'm just looking at
he
the,
spoke
I'm
it
looking
into
the
receiver.
Receiver.
Right there
no.
on the wall.
Yeah. We're getting there.
I think we rejected
oh
again.
My gosh.
See if he opens it.
Yeah.
This is unexpected.
I'm sorry, is there a problem? You didn't mishear me, did you? Please speak the code into the receiver. Otherwise we can't get on with the story. This is a crucial step.
Never!
Oh,
never, boss man!
No!
You can't control me!
What?
Even
okay,
in this ending
fine.
You can't control
what
me.
What happened to working
it?
With
but
the narrator?
You know it's pretty humiliating to bring you this far, only for you to suddenly decide you have better things to do. I asked you for this one single thing, for your respect.
The kind of respect Stanley shows for his choices. He knows what it means to take a story seriously. If you didn't want to see what I had to show you, then why did you come here? You had a choice, you know. You could have gone through the door on the right.
I could have, though.
Whatever the hell you wanted over there. Why did you come this way? Speak. Say something to me. Explain yourself, you coward.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
What is this?
What?
What is this?
Stanley? Hello? Are you... Is everything okay? Stanley, please. I need you to make a choice. I need you to walk through the door. Are you listening to me? Can you hear me? Is everything all right? Stanley, this is important. The story needs you. It needs you to make a decision. It cannot exist without you. Do you understand me? Whatever choice you make is just fine. They're both correct. You cannot be wrong here. We can work together. I'll accept whatever you do. I simply need you to take that step forward, please. Choose. Do something.
No.
Anything. This is more important than you can ever know. I need this. The story needs it. So, you hear me? Are you there? Are you listening to this? Stanley, are you there? Okay. It's okay, I can wait. You need time to decide. Time to make sure your choice is correct. That is
the poor narrator. So see, this is my poor narrator.
Right. Oh, you were stabbing him in the back a minute ago.
Decide what's the right thing to do. Take as much time as you need.
Ah, that was such a good ending!
What?
That was such a good ending!
Oh my gosh!
That was so deep and intense!
Wow.
Wow, that was wild!
I'm so interested in what the chat has to say here.
That was wild!
Oh, that Sierra Makomi sounds so sad. Monet Girl 02, the true ending, yes.
Right?
This is the true ending.
Right, I was going to say that seemed like the true ending. That seemed like the actual ending of the game.
Zip 0214 says, wait, it's over.
Wow.
Wow.
So it really is like...
Johannes Hall says, there are more endings, though. Wow.
That was incredible. That was so good.
And Skylar just said, you monsters.
So what would have... So the question I have... So that was literally disobey the narrator until the absolute very end. That was disobey him in every single way possible, right?
Yeah.
So what happens if you do speak the code?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors...
That's the thing. We don't know.
I know. So
we'd have to get all the way back there.
We can find out, Steph. Well,
we'd have to get all the way back there. We have to play through all those times.
Just to admire it.
It was only like one time.
Was it?
Yeah.
Standing now in this incredible room, but Stanley for the first but eager
okay,
to get
go,
back
go for
to business.
We can also pick up the phone.
Open door on
you know.
I know, we can pick up the phone, but I want to get back to that area and see what happens if you speak the
code.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Okay.
How wild was that?
Right?
That was really good.
Oh my gosh.
And the fact that they wrote the credits and stuff, like obviously that felt like the true ending of the game.
Oh yeah, that was. Everyone's saying that that was the real
ending. Wow.
Wow.
So the narrator is just utterly beat.
But the fact is,
he's just beaten down.
The story can't go on without you.
Right. Stanley's true purpose.
There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley.
Savage AF. That was Savage AF, man.
Stop trying to make every decision.
Well, I said the ending was savage.
I'm not asking for me.
And also me. I am also Savage AF.
Go.
Which means, as foretold.
This is it, Stanley.
Right?
Your chance to redeem yourself.
Savage as foretold!
To work aside, to let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Here we go, so we're here.
All right.
Phone rings.
Let's pick up the phone.
Nope.
That's
what?
Her, Stanley.
You don't want to try the phone ending
no,
first time?
No, you can't.
Aww.
Did you just unplug the phone?
Here we go.
No, that wasn't supposed to be a choice. How did you do that? You actually chose incorrectly? I didn't even know that was possible. Let me double check.
Yeah, like I said, I want to see.
Oh my gosh.
I want to see all the way up to that ending. But then you say the words.
Stanley picks up the phone.
Right. Oh, Dobby Dude says you can't speak.
His wife,
And the two
Toko Shorin Lunch says you cannot speak the codes. Stanley's mute.
No!
Stanley's mute.
Stanley's mute, sure, but...
No, you can't. Alfred Jones says don't do it. Hashtag love to the narrator says Julie Anthony.
Because I consciously made the choice there not to click on the receiver.
Ash Kamer says Stanley don't speak. No, that's not possible. You can't speak, says Crazy Monkey. You will not be able to speak the codes.
Darn it.
You're not Stanley. You're a real person.
Oh, well then we'll branch off before this.
Okay.
I was so mistaken. This is why you've been able to make correct and incorrect
choices.
I don't
think we can go anywhere else.
Letting you run
all
around
the
other
doing locked up.
Well, when he puts us back into that room, we'll go left and we'll stay there.
Okay, I think we'll end up in the same place. Ignored
even the most basic safety
protocol
for real-world decision-making, or did you not grasp the severity of the situation? Well, I won't have that kind of risk on my watch.
Instructional video.
I'm going to stop the game for a moment so we can educate you properly on safe decision-making in the real world. Please observe this helpful instructional video.
Great, right, I'm gonna look over on Twitter.
It's the best part of
being
a
learn
real person.
How to make
but
choices.
If used incorrectly, can also be the most dangerous. For example, in this scenario, a hypothetical real person named Steven has a choice.
At Jen Balsam says, this is crazy. I've never seen a game like this before. Let's see, Caitlin GG Live says, it's nearly 2 a.m. in the UK and I'm still up.
Living in a 30-kilometer radius of his house.
At Henry Mo and a bunch of numbers says, this game is outstanding, honestly.
The real world makes sense. And at no time should you make a choice that does not conform to rational logic.
At Har Har, 239 says, get on that desk.
Does not make sense.
That.
In all likelihood, that person is not real.
We got on the desk.
Allow
we got
the
out
person
the window.
To finish their thought, then provide an excuse why you cannot continue talking. Turn to a partner and practice saying, "My goodness, is it 4:30? I'm supposed to be having a back sack and crack."
My goodness, is it 4:30? I'm supposed to be having a back sack and crack.
Excellent. Making choices on a regular basis is the best part of a healthy decision-making process.
Thank you for understanding. My back sack and crack cannot wait.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
More than eight, less, and finally.
Goodbye.
You wonder if your choices are actually meaningful.
Goodbye.
You'll ever make a significant
is it 4:30?
Goodbye.
I'm supposed to be having a back sack and crack.
I'm supposed to be having a back sack and crack. Is it 4:30? Goodbye.
Problems
goodbye. Back sack and crack. Goodbye.
Feeling should subside. At this time, your instructor will guide you in an exercise to test and reinforce the material covered in this video.
Skip, help me.
Ah, welcome back.
Oh, hey.
You may have noticed that this room has begun to deteriorate as a result of narrative contradiction. But not to worry. Now that you're properly informed on good decision-making, we're going to revisit a choice you made just a few minutes ago and see what the correct thing to do would have been. This way, please.
Put yourself in this situation. You only have yourself to play.
Everyone wants us to restart. Okay. Everyone wants us to pause and restart.
Now that we know your choices are meaningful, we can't have you jumping off the platform and dying. Imagine the main character dying
senselessly
halfway
Holy
through
cow.
The story. That story would make no sense at all. We just need to get you home as soon as possible before the narrative contradiction gets any worse. Unfortunately, it seems this place is not well equipped to deal with reality.
I'm not sure why everyone... Why does everyone want us to restart?
Because I think that we're...
There's no new...
There's no new ending. All right. I don't think there is either.
Or is there?
But, really, I mean, we're almost to the end. Not. You might as well just
Or is there?
I'm pretty sure there's not.
Or is there?
Almost there. You'll take the door on the left, back to the correct ending. The story will have resolution once again, and you'll be home free in the real world.
Mm-hmm. See, there you go.
And how?
There it is.
Now remember, all you need to do is behave exactly
as Stanley. We're gonna take the left, because last time we took the right one.
I'm
just curious.
And always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
I'm ready.
Go.
Did it for you, buddy. It's you and me, narrator. Through to the end. Let's do it.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
Huh.
Feeling
so it does put you back on the
track. Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
No broom closet.
Wait, you can't get into the broom closet,
no.
though. That's weird.
Yeah. And there's still
oh,
no
and you're still
to the staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's
I mean, they
office.
Still take the choices away.
They do, but I was breaking the game before. Whereas this is me, I'm saying like, oh, I'm okay playing with the...
No.
See, no, it's interesting, because like, to me, I would have made a path of like, the person is still continuing to disobey
mm-hmm.
as, hey, he took the right door, but taking the left door means, hey...
You're back on track.
You're yeah, that you learning the instructional video and this and that is now the player saying, okay, I'm willing to play along with the narrator.
But he does. But he realizes that you're a real person now, so
but,
you have
but
to...
But I'm a real person who has been won over.
Stepping inside his manager's office, Stanley was
see,
once
I'm surprised.
Again
I thought for sure that...
But your choices have meaning
life.
Now. They can't let
Shocked,
you actually make
unraveled,
them.
Unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated
right.
this.
Go for it.
Until he saw the door with a voice receiver next to it. Surely behind this door lay all the answers to his questions. And beyond all probability, he knew the passcode. He had seen it on his boss's computer just last week. Nightshark 115.
Okay.
Was this the code to open the door? Would it still work? There was only one way to find out. Stanley had been trained never to speak up, but now he would draw from within himself the courage to face the unknown.
Okay.
I'm ready.
He
ready.
Drew a sharp
I'm ready.
Breath.
Okay.
And then spoke the code.
Here we go.
Everyone now.
Nightshark.
Nightshark.
115.
Nightshark 115.
No, let me choose.
Maybe
let
if we do
choose.
It together. Maybe if we do it together. One,
Night-
two, three.
Nightshark
115.
Shoot, okay, so I guess that is the ending. Darn it. I thought for sure.
Yeah.
Darn it. Okay. Well, we're
Shoot.
We're all
right, restart.
Poop. I thought that was it. I thought for sure that would work.
I say we finish out the nice girlfriend ending.
Mm-hmm.
As in...
Pick up the phone.
Pick up the phone?
I say, so we pick up the phone.
Okay.
What could it mean?
That's probably the last one we have time for, so we'll do that one last.
Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Nightshark!
He missed a meme.
Nightshark 115.
Nightshark!
Nightshark!
Right.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room. And
silly.
Stanley knew it perfectly well.
Boy Lounge, you gotta
Stanley
check it out, man.
Stanley knew it.
I gotta check it out.
First,
Stanley knew
it. Admire it.
Mm.
Stanley
Gideon away,
but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his
go,
left.
Go, Stanley, go! Go! Don't take that open door! No! I saw you do the fake out there.
He had no idea what hit him.
No.
He wasn't 5 years ago.
There we go.
Ready? Ready, go!
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've got
I'm coming to you, girlfriend! I'm coming to you, my love!
Your enemy
love of my life! Tis the season of love.
Your trust in someone else
I'm here for you.
But the fact is that
Stanley,
the
story Stanley, coming home.
Stanley,
Stanley,
I'm running home to your open arms.
There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley.
Nah.
Someone you've forgotten about.
Why has he forgotten about
stop
her,
trying
Stanley?
To make every decision
Stanley.
By yourself.
He was too busy in his day-to-day operations. His work was too much.
He's married to his work.
Stanley.
Your chance to
I'm coming to you, honey.
To put your work aside. Here. To let her back into your life.
I'm ready for her
She's
back in my
waiting.
Life. There we go.
So random that there's
That's
this.
That's her, Stanley. You need to
do
be
it.
The one to do this. To reach out to
well,
her.
Well, if you just let it ring forever.
If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the
Ghost
phone.
Voicemail.
Ghost voicemail. Okay, here we go.
All right, do it.
Fade to white. Go to my apartment. Meet my wife. Meet the girl of my dreams. Oh, 427, it's my apartment!
Oh, Stanley, is that you? Hold on, sweetie. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm just pulling the bread out of the oven.
She sounds hot!
She sounds like a carbaholic!
Okay,
I love it!
All right, now, I want you to come in and tell me all about
your damn
oh! What?!
Oh, come on.
Yes!
Did you actually think you had a loving wife? They'd want to commit their life to you. I'm trying to make a point
no.
here, Stanley. I'm trying to get you to see something. Come inside. Let me show you what's really going on here.
Oh!
Oh, no!
Oh, no!
Oh,
Stanley! No! Stanley!
Oh, what a drab apartment you have, Stanley.
She's still a looker!
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stanley.
Wait, what?
What?
Excuse me? No, what? No, what is
what?
This? What is this?
What?
E.
E?
Stanley is quite a boring fellow.
He has a job that demands nothing of him, and every button that he pushes is a reminder of the inconsequential nature of his existence.
No!
Look at him there, pushing buttons, doing exactly what he's told to do. Now he's pushing a button. Now he's eating lunch. Now
I just ate lunch! No. I am at home!
He's coming back to work.
And at work at the same time!
Sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life.
Can't press E? Apparently not.
No. Just O.
I pressed O.
Zero. It's probably zero.
No, it made a sound.
It did.
Crystal.
Aww.
Can you go to the bedroom?
It's the same. It's the same dimensions as your
cube.
Cube. Aww.
What about my hot wife?
Ha, hottie.
Ooh, X to watch TV.
Great.
Where's TV? Oh, there it is.
Oh.
X. Worst show ever.
Man.
Truly traditional TV is dying.
I was about to say, this is on the caliber with GT Live. Just kidding.
I've seen better. Oh, here we go. P to spend time with the boys.
What? Oh, man. Nothing really happens.
Oh, this is sad.
Nothing really changes.
Oh, this is brutal.
Oh, man.
Let me to my bedroom, at least.
Robert Mears says this is one of my favorite endings.
I did not see this one coming. Again, the game has done.
Debbie Dude says you broke it.
Ooh, eight.
Olivia B says the room is changing. A bunch of people are saying, or actually just one person. Austin Sherwood is saying N.
Get out of my way, honey. I'm trying to cook something. Excuse me, dear. Excuse me. I'm trying to cook something here, dear.
Man,
honey,
you broke the game.
Hey, honey, I need to get access to the stove. Get out of my way! Oh, I have to tell my kids a story.
Oh,
this is really depressing.
This is so sad.
Wow,
Stanley, you can do better. You can do better in your life, Stanley. Now.
Press F to tell your wife that you love her. Hey.
Hey.
I love you.
She doesn't seem to care.
You're so cold and emotionless all the time. All I do is give, give, give. And all you do is take, take, take.
Restart. Broken. You broke it.
I don't think so. Clearly it is not broken, guys. If it was broken, would I still be getting prompts?
Right.
No.
Alex Ogden says, best ending ever. Oh, man.
Maybe I'll have everyone Jason is do saying this one for 4 hours. Broke it. We didn't break it.
I know. It's got this, and you can't break this game. The room is a lie. Let's see.
Two, to be at work in the morning.
Yeah.
Yeah, yes. I gotta be there.
Might as well.
Oh, I'm rocking out on these button presses, by the way. They're like QuickTime events.
You
I am all
on
over
it.
Them
you are
right
on
now.
It.
Ready? Here we go. Here we go. Ready for it? Here we go. Here we go. I'm ready. Nine, to do nothing. Nine.
Nine to question nothing.
Oh, question nothing? Done. Did
done.
It. I question nothing. Just give me buttons to press. This is the best. Gameplay 10 out of 10. Would press buttons again. Come
good,
on. Give me another. Will. Give me another. Give me another. Give me another. Here we go. Come on. Come on, game. Show me your worst.
Man, this is the worst.
Boss battle.
This is the worst.
Boss
this is,
battle.
This is the game showing us its worst. This is the worst.
Boss battle. Come on. Come on, Gabe.
Oh, man.
No? Come on, Gabe. I know there's an ending. There's got to be an ending
he
here.
He said the room should be changing. The chat keeps saying that the room should be changing and isn't. Like, every time we press something, it should become more and more like our office.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, that's that's a bummer.
Are you failing?
Yeah, maybe I'm failing my button
the
press.
The quick time offense are fast.
Maybe I'm making the
so they're like,
wrong
no,
decisions.
It really is a joke. They're supposed to be talking and stuff.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
what?
The room is supposed to be changing into the office, and the narrator isn't talking.
How'd we get the broken copy?
Aww. Oh, we got broken.
I'm glad to see Matt Pat break the game, says Brenda.
I tell you what, man, if there's one thing we're good at on GT Live, it's breaking games.
Oh, yeah, getting glitchy copies and stuff. Who knows where he digs up these copies.
Like, when we were playing Inside, and, like, none of the shadows just decided to show up. And so instead of, like, having really easy hide-in-the-shadow puzzles, it was like, do your best to predict where the shadow is in this game so you don't get caught.
P.S. You're not going to be able to do it.
Shoot. Wait. So that's it.
Okay.
Aww. No.
It's we still got to see the sadness of this ending, I think. That his work and his home is all the same.
That was a big surprise. Yeah. I did not see that one coming, I have to say. I thought for sure, especially when the wife's voice was on the other side, I'm like,
I was like, oh, this will be a happy ending.
This is a good ending. No. Huh. That was crushing, and I want to see more of that one.
I know.
So maybe we'll play this one final time. Not tomorrow, maybe next week. And maybe this time Jason won't kill babies by peeing. I'll let you interpret how that happened on your own. Stop peeing, Jason. Anyway, that's it for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. And remember, that is just a stream. A live stream. Thanks for tuning in. Or did you? Did any of your choices actually matter? Or are you just mindlessly clicking buttons?
What are you choosing to do now?
Are you just mindlessly typing into the chat right now?
Are you sure you chose that?
Are you sure? Or are you truly making a choice?
Say goodbye to us in the chat.
We're going to choose to say goodbye to you.
Or are we?
Torashies, bye.
Slagtastic says goodbye.
David Krutt says GG.
Tanya Rawl says yay, bye.
Daith Do says bye.
Mystify 101 says bye.
Abstract Dreamer also says bye.
Nicole Spark says bye.
Misty Faye 101 says bye.
Caleb Weller says bye.
Dead God. Red, Steph, ask Matt where he got his hoodie at.
Where'd you get your hoodie?
You got it for me.
It's an Assassin's Creed replica hoodie. There's a website for it if you look it up.
If you just look up
Assassin's Creed hoodie. It's like inspired by.
I'm an assassin! Woo!
Isn't it cute? Anyway. Fire charge.